space camp number 2. From here we launch our great mission, with of course proper rations.
Oh, yeah.
So Alice, how many did we pull the Sunday gig?
Oh, about 4.
A crowd of 4?
On a good day.
Well, 4's not bad, the 4 Gospels, the 4 Horsemen of the Apocalypse, or the 4 Rocky movies until they made Rocky 5. Very bad.
Well, it might go up to 5 if Mr. Newitt's bow is set down.
Okay, so we've got Miss Lettitia, Mr. Pickle and Mr. Horton, and who else?
Well, sometimes Hugo comes, but not very often.
He's the 4th one, isn't he?
Oh, I mentioned Mr. Newitt with the bows.
He's the 5th one.
Was he? Oh, sorry. Okay, Oh, me! Thickness, how?
What about Christmas? Christmas?
Oh, Christmas, that's special.
How many?
3. Mrs. Cropley visits her sister.
Right. So, what exactly do you do when you're not in charge of crowd control?
Well, I help the teacher at the nursery school.
Oh.
Art's my forte.
Oh, so it is.
Reverend Pottle said I was an undiscovered genius.
Did he? Did he? Very remarkable man. Now, let's see. Ooh. Rabina, for Sunday school?
No, Holy Communion.
Unorthodox?
Well, the Reverend had a tendency to get a little tipsy, so I used it instead of the wine to avoid, you know.
Quite right, I've just been around the Lord last supper. The good Lord might have had a sweet. Oh, Alice, are we going to be all right?
Oh, I'm going to support you all the way.
Oh, then we can't fail.
And I know a lot about tropical fish.
Splendid, splendid. Fish for me.
Yes, I don't know much about them, I'm afraid.
Oh, watch and learn, kid. Watch and learn.
Now, I have written to the bishop requesting that she be removed from her position. If you've any objections, if you want to see our village a laughingstock, or if you believe, like most Anglicans, that this is heresy, do speak up now.
Sorry, I'm late. Been visiting the new parishioners. I think they'd be less surprised if the new vicar was Mr. Blobby. Right, did I miss anything important?
Yes, we've drafted a letter to the bishop.
Oh, great. Oh, poor Bertie. Only gets dull circulars saying, are the priest as gay as Larry Hagman? Is it Larry Hagman? No, it's not Larry, is it?
Let's get on. Frank, as the parish clerk, I think perhaps you should read the letter.
I'd rather not.
Very well. Jim?
Okay, I'll read it. From the Dibley Parish Council.
Oh, sorry, I'm late. It's like the big ride of Owen cows in my stomach.
And reading a letter from the council to the bishop.
Ah, right.
My lord, sorry to take up your valuable time, but an important subject has arisen.
Perhaps you should mention his trip to Africa, like, welcome back from your triumphant conference. He'll be putty in your hands.
Thanks.
What a stunning tie, Hugo. The girls just aren't safe, are they?
Welcome back from your triumphant conference.
Well, he'll never refuse you now.
Sorry to take up your valuable time.
Good, good.
But an important subject has arisen. Your new choice for vicar has now arrived, and we are deeply unhappy about her and feel that she won't fit into our community. We are angry that we should be used as an experiment ground for the excesses of the modern church, and we ask that you reconsider this disastrous appointment. It's signed from the Dibley Parish Council.
Phew, well, you certainly know how to win a girl. Is that all of you, is it?
Yes, it is.
Except for me, actually. Potty Pottle was a right old woman, and if we must have a lass, I'd prefer a young one. Especially one with such an interesting taste in jumpers.
Oh, thanks! My grandmother admitted this. She's blind.
I say, did we actually vote on this?
No. I don't know.
Of course we did.
I'll check on that. No, in fact, it appears that we have forgotten to vote.
Oh, that's excellent news.
But we all agreed.
I didn't. I propose we vote now and we give the Reverend a chance at least to see how she does on Sunday.
All of those in favour of Mr. Newitt's excellent proposal. All of those against.
This is ridiculous. The proof of the pudding will be in the eating. Our little community does not react well to a vicar in high heels and supports my desire to maintain the standards of this village and the Church of England that it is today.
I take it that's a no.
Yes.
Guard your father's hands when he's angry. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'd like to start singing Zippity Doodah. This is such a thrill to see you all here today, but I think we'll stick with the tradition, singing hymn number 119. My childhood, I thought I'd be a supermodel, marry Eric Clapton or David Soul. But then I read the Sermon on the Mount, and it was fantastic. So I decided to give the catwalk away and give the dog collar a try. So here I am at your service, anytime, anywhere. But if you come to see me early in the morning, make sure you wear dark glasses, because before my face falls into place, I look like Keith Richards. It's true, I do, really. Now let's sing hymn number 300. I think it sounds best if you shout the bread of heaven a bit. Where do you want me to hang the blind?
I'm not asking for the moon, and I think it's a brilliant idea. If the council would just back us to get it started, I'm sure they wouldn't regret it.
Bravo! Excellent idea!
How much exactly is the grant that you are after?
£7 million.
And what if Dibley is not successful in its bid for the 2032 Olympics?
Ah, well, with the ski slope, we can host the Winter Olympics instead.
Right. Well, thank you very much, Lettitia, and supporters, for that excellent proposal. We will, of course, give it due consideration. It's excrement.
Oh, how disappointing.
Bloody Olympics. If you're a pitch, you would have been out of you, are.
No. He's right. We should go for the Commonwealth Games first, build up to the Olympics.
It's a mad old world, isn't it?
Right, moving on. Any other requests for funding? Bigger.
All right, well, as you know, Lent starts tomorrow.
That's right, and as it's Shrove Tuesday, I thought I'd bring some of my pancakes to share with you.
Hot diggity dog, Mrs. C.
And here they are. These are the lard and fish cake. And these are the plain ones, with just a hint of liver. Would you like one, Mr. Chairman?
I'd just as soon eat my own scrotum, thank you, yeah. Right, Vicar, you were saying?
Yes, well, as I said, Ash Wednesday starts tomorrow, and I thought, well, why don't we all give up something for Lent?
Like bondage, you mean?
And every time we fail, we put a pound in this box. For instance, Owen, you could give up swearing, couldn't you?
I don't swear.
No. Yes, you do.
I bloody do not.
Pound in the box! Pound in the box!
What, bloody isn't swearing?
I'm afraid it is.
Bloody is just bloody. Now, bollocks is swearing and arse, but bloody is just a useful adjective with biblical overtones. And she can give up cooking garbage. I've tasted better slurry than that.
And, Jim, perhaps you could give up dithering.
No. Yes, I'm not sure.
Pound the box!
Ah, bloody hell. I mean, bugger.
Pound the box!
Pound the box!
Ass!
Right, well, Frank, perhaps you should give up being such a pedantic old fart with the minutes.
Good suggestion. Should I record that as fart? Or F asterisk asterisk T?
Pound the box!
And, David, perhaps you'd be a little bit more friendly to everyone, do you think?
Yes, Father. Everybody's absolutely fed up to the back teeth with you shouting at them all the time, like some great, big, bold, shouty-type person. Except me, of course, I don't think.
He's got a point, sir.
Well, very well. Easy peasy. Mind you, I would like to know where all this money is going towards.
All right, well, I thought we might start a video club at the hall on a Friday night for the people of the parish who can't afford videos of their own.
I got a video, but it don't work. I plugged it in and switched it on, but nothing.
I didn't think you even had a TV.
No, I don't. So I plugged the video into the radio instead.
Right, very good. Well, it's not a bad idea, but what, pray tell, is St. Geraldine going to be giving up?
Oh, well, I thought I might have a bubble bath, because I absolutely love the stuff, all that bubbly, wobbly, wobbly, all your noses and your toesies, that sort of thing.
Or you could give up chocolate.
Oh, no, I don't eat enough of it for it to really hurt me.
Chocolate.
Oh, you don't think I'm going to eat all this by myself, do you? This is for the tired little orphan children of the village. Starved love and tenderness.
Oh! Chocolate.
All right, okay, chocolate.
And now we'll see who's got some self-control. Meeting closed. Come on, Hugo, let's go.